For avian influenza, we have what we call the National Animal Health Lab Network, and the only one we have in New York State is the one here at Cornell. We even have neighboring states that send their samples to us. So, of course, when we heard that the H5N1, it was in the United States, we were already on alert.
On February 19th, 2022, a strain of highly pathogenic avian influenza was found for the first time in New York State. This deadly virus has devastated millions of domestic poultry and wild birds across the U.S. and the globe. Soon after the New York outbreak, Cornell's Animal Health Diagnostic Center and New York State's Department of Agriculture and Markets were advising farmers on how to keep their flocks safe.
What are the signs that you would want to look for in your poultry? Well, first and foremost, sudden death without clinical signs. Additional signs may be lack of energy, lack of appetite, discoloration of the comb, of the eyelids.
Every chicken that comes in here that has respiratory signs, that has neurological signs, is tested. And we send that to our molecular diagnostic lab, and we expect to have those results in 24 hours. Our testing is important not just for the health of people around here, but also for the state to put in control measures, because it can spread very rapidly. If they have H5N1, we have to destroy the rest of the flock. That's the United States Department of Agriculture policy.
Cornell's testing and outreach efforts have been key to keeping New York State's incidence of the virus remarkably low. Increased biosecurity protocols, including reducing flock contact with outside farms and heightened sanitization measures, have also helped to keep farmers and their flocks in the clear.
Being able to have a strong position against avian influenza is certainly a benefit for our company, certainly to the community. As part of our overall biosecurity plan, we maintain close contact with the Cornell Duck Research Laboratory and the avian pathology resources so that we know what to do. It's a partnership that's really critical to the individual farms and to the state.
It's a team effort between Cornell College of Veterinary Medicine, New York State Agriculture and Markets, and also the farmers out there.